Good morning, dear students. Welcome once again. This time we are going to study class 7 general knowledge. Okay, it's a short session. So try to take care of this chapter because this is about interesting inventors. We will try to learn who were the inventors, who had invented what and what was the means by which they have invented something. Okay. This is the chapter number 52, Interesting Inventors. The first question, the 1879 Nobel Prize winners for medicine, Sir Godfrey Hounsfield and Alan Cormack, were neither doctors nor physiologists. So, 1879 Nobel Prize winners for medicine. Two persons were there, Sir Godfrey Hounsfield and Alan Cormack. They were neither doctors nor physiologists. Remember, they were neither the doctor nor physiologist. For what did they win the prize? That means, what was the cause? Because of that, they win the prize. It was just because they invented the CAT scan. Yes, the CAT scan, very famous computed tomography. Okay, computed automatic tomography, CAT, CAT scan is invented by Godfrey Hounsfield and Alan Cormack. Okay, so always remember that this CAT scan was invented by Sir Alan Cormack and Godfrey Hounsfield. Okay. Another question. In an attempt to help himself and his weakening eyesight, who created the first pair of bifocal glasses? So this is also interesting. Just because the inventor itself was suffering from eyesight problem because of weakening of the eyesight, that's why he created, he developed, he invented the pair of bifocal glasses. Okay, who was he? Yes, he was Benjamin Franklin. Yes, so he was Benjamin Franklin who, in an attempt to help himself and his weakening eyesight, created the first pair of bifocal glasses. Right, so he was Benjamin Franklin. Okay, yes. Your third question. This scientist was called. So this scientist was called to help locate and extract the bullet that shot a US president. Okay, that means this scientist was called to locate and extract the bullet which shot a US president. That means he might came over there as an investigator, isn't it? So he was called to locate and extract the bullet that was shot to a US president. Okay, which led him to invent something. Because of that investigation, invented something. Obviously, in this way only the invention usually occurs. If you find something, if you think about something, you can get out with something. Okay? So this led him to invent something. Name the scientist also as well as his invention. Okay? So the scientist was Alexander Graham Bell. You might be very much aware of this scientist. Alexander Graham Bell, who has discovered telephone, who has invented telephones. Moreover, safety pin, he has also discovered or invented, right? So, Alexander Graham Bell was the scientist, and what was his invention? His invention was a metal detector. The metal detector which you see on the railway stations or in the airports, okay? With the help of which police and everybody is searching and security is there, which can make a beep sound, okay, whenever there is a metal. So he has invented it. The metal detector is invented by Graham Bell, Alexander Graham Bell. Okay, and he has only invented the metal detector because of which you can easily identify a person, whether a person is going with a metal or not. Okay, so it was his big invention. Number four, he worked as a laboratory assistant for the inventor of the safety lamp. See, he worked as a laboratory assistant and he has invented safety lamp. Okay, he worked as a laboratory assistant for the inventor of safety lamp. The person who invented the safety lamp, under this person he has worked as a laboratory assistant. Moreover, another statement gives a clue that Humphrey Davy, okay, that means safety lamp was discovered or invented by whom? Humphrey Davy. You might have read in science, right? So safety lamp is invented by Humphrey Davy. Under him he worked as a laboratory assistant and went on to become more famous, and this person become more famous than his mentor, than his master, for his work in electromagnetic induction. So he is very famous scientist, he is very famous inventor who has given a remarkable feature or work in the field of electromagnetic induction. You have to name the scientist. It was Michael Faraday. Okay, so Michael Faraday he was, who has worked under Humphrey Davy, and he became famous after doing remarkable work or finding out remarkable features about electromagnetic induction. Right? Yes, electricity has both the effects of the magnet as well as of the electrical effects, right? So it was electromagnetic induction. So he was Michael Faraday, who has given a remarkable features of electromagnetic induction. Another question, developed by Paul Hawkins. So it was developed by Paul Hawkins. It is computer system used in sports such as cricket, tennis and football to visually track the trajectory of the ball. Trajectory of the ball, the path of the ball, and display its most likely path as a moving image. Name the invention. So it is developed by Paul Hawkins. Computer system which is used in the sports of cricket, tennis and football, which makes a trajectory and shows the path in which the ball is moving, and it may go and hit the stumps in the cricket or where it will fall in the ground. Okay, it is Hawkeye. Yes, Hawkeye. Okay, if you are interested in cricket, you might have seen, if the umpire is unable to give them LBW, then players go for it, right? They ask for third umpire. Then with the help of Hawkeye, they use to find the trajectory or the path of the ball, and they will declare a batsman whether he is out or not on the cost of LBW, right? Yes, so it is Hawkeye which visually track the trajectory of the ball and display the most likely path as moving, okay, image. Another question, name the well-known adventurer known for his films about the mysteries of the deep seas, who invented the aqualung, a portable underwater breathing apparatus. So if you go into the water, you need aqualung, right? Portable underwater breathing apparatus. Portable means small, which you can carry. Underwater breathing apparatus, underwater oxygen, right? Underwater oxygen mask for apparatus, right? Who is well-known adventurer? Okay, and moreover, he was also known for his films on the mysteries of deep seas. Who has invented it? It was Jacques Cousteau. JACQUESCOUSTEAU. It was Jacques Cousteau who has. Yes. So solved out the mysteries. He has made the films also on the mysteries of deep sea, as well as he invented the portable underwater breathing apparatus. Okay, so it is Jack Skowski. Better known as an author, he is an author. He patented three inventions of his own. He has made three inventions on his own. The first, the most famous being the self-pasting scrapbook. Self-pasting scrapbook is there. Name the author or the inventor. Okay, so he is Samuel Clemens. Okay, it is the name of the author, Samuel Clemens. Inventor is Mark Twain. Okay, or you can put it in this fashion. He is known as author, so he is Mark Twain. Okay, he patented three inventions of his own, and most famous being the self-pasting scrapbook. So he was Samuel Clemens. Okay, so he was Mark Twain. Okay, that means he is writing with another name. Okay, Samuel Clemens, Mark Twain. Okay. Number 8, he studied the circulation of blood. Okay, that means this person studied the circulation of blood and the action of the eye. That means circulation of blood and action of the eye is studied by this very famous scientist. He studied the effect of the moon on the tides. He also studied the effect of moon on the tides and surmised the nature of fossil cells. And he also got out, come up with the facts of the nature of fossil cells. He invented a large number of ingenious machines, including an underwater diving suit. So he has also invented large number of ingenious machines, including underwater diving suit. But most of us do not know of him as a scientist. Who is he? Though he has invented so many things, but we do not know much about him as a scientist. Who is he? He is Leonardo da Vinci. Yes, Leonardo da Vinci, who is the very famous painter. Painter of what? Mona Lisa, right? Yes. So he studied the circulation of blood also, as well as the action of the eyes. Moreover, he studied the effect of the moon on the tides. Okay, he invented large number of ingenious machines also, including underwater diving suit. Underwater diving suit is his invention only. He was Leonardo da Vinci. Okay, moving on to the next, time and motion. First question, which of these does not show periodic motion? The to and fro motion, right, is called periodic motion. A girl is swinging. Yes, it is a periodic motion. Bob of a pendulum. Yes, it is a periodic motion, to and fro movement. A moving train. If a train is moving, it goes in straight path or in zigzag path. So this does not show periodic motion. So moving train is the answer. This is not a periodic motion. Okay, strings of a guitar. When you pluck a string of guitar, it will make a vibration to and fro, right? Yes. So it is moving train which does not show periodic motion. If you change the unit of speed from kilometer per hour to meter per second, you will have to multiply with what number? You will have to multiply with 5 by 18. Okay. So if you want to convert kilometer per hour to meter per second, you have to multiply this with 5 by 18, because 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter, right? And 1 hour is equal to 16 to 60, that is 3600 meter seconds. So 1000 divided by 3600, you cancel it out, you get 5 by 18, right? Yes. So 5 by 18 is the right answer. Okay. What is the unit of speed? The unit of speed is meter per second. Yes, so meter per second is the unit of speed. Meter per second, okay? Yes, it is the unit of speed. Another question. A force that acts on a body moving in a circular path. The force that acts on a body moving in a circular path and is directed towards the center around which the body is moving is called dash. That means, suppose if there is a body and if you move it in circular path, you take a stone, tie it with thread and you rotate it. That means it is moving in circular path directed towards the center. That means from the center you are rotating it, right? So the force is directed towards the center around which the body is moving. What kind of this force we call? We call it as centripetal force. Okay? So body is moving in circular path, force directed towards the center, right? So this kind of force is called centripetal force. Clear? Yes, this kind of force is called a centripetal force. Always remember this thing. What kind of line does the distance time graph of a uniform motion show? If it is uniform motion, that means the distance traveled by object in equal interval of time, that means the same distance traveled by the object in equal interval of time. Okay, so obviously it will be a diagonal line. Okay, if this is a distance, it shows time, then your distance time graph will be like this, like a diagonal. Okay, so in a distance time graph, uniform motion always show a diagonal line or a straight line. Okay, yes, so you can make it out with the help of taking some data, like if a body is traveling 10 kilometer in 10 hours, then 20 kilometer in 20 hours, like that you can make a uniform motion and you make a graph. Okay, now another question. If you move 50 minutes in 10 seconds, if you are moving 50 meters in 10 seconds, what is your speed? What speed is your distance traveled by time taken? Distance traveled is 50 meter, time taken is 10 seconds, so distance upon time. So distance is 50 divided by 10, it will be 5 meter per second. Speed is equal to what? Speed is equal to distance upon time. So distance is 50 meter, time is 10 seconds, so speed is equal to distance by time, distance divided by time. 50 by 10 means 5, so it is 5 meter per second. Okay, very simple question. So in this way you can calculate the speed. A car travels 400 meter in 40 seconds. What is the speed of the car? Again the same question. Distance is 400 meter, time is 40 seconds. So speed of the car is distance upon time. So distance is 400 meter and time is 40 seconds. 400 divided by 40, it makes 10, right? So 10 meter per second is the speed of the car. Okay, another question. Which instrument is used to measure the distance traveled by a vehicle? So which instrument is used to measure the distance traveled by vehicle? It is odometer. You might have seen in your bike or in car the meter that shows the distance, how much distance the car or the vehicle has traveled. That is called odometer. Okay, speedometer tells about the speed, odometer tells about the distance. Okay, you can clarify it with your father or mother, whoever is driving. Where is odometer? They will show you. Okay, so odometer gives us the measurement of distance traveled by the vehicle. Okay, so this is about this chapter. Moving on to the next chapter about the Indian scientists. These are also very important scientists. Who is known as the chief architect of India's nuclear program? He was Sir Jahangir Homi Bhabha. Homi Bhabha is the chief architect of India's nuclear program. So the chief architect of India's nuclear program was Homi Bhabha. Okay, Homi Bhabha is the correct answer. Who played a leading role in the Green Revolution in India? It was M.S. Swaminathan. Always remember, the Green Revolution is brought out in India just because of his efforts. M.S. Swaminathan. And what is Green Revolution? Increase in the production of food crops. Okay, increase in the production of food crops is known as Green Revolution. Okay, so M.S. Swaminathan has played a leading role in the Green Revolution. Okay, which former president of India is known as Missile Man of India? Everybody knows about this answer. Yes, the Missile Man of our country is Mr. A.P.J. Abdul Kalam, right? So Mr. A.P.J. Abdul Kalam is known as Missile Man of India. Which scientist won the Nobel Prize in 1930 and the Bharat Ratna in 1954? He was Sir C.V. Raman. Okay, C.V. Raman has won the Nobel Prize in 1930 as well as he won Bharat Ratna in 1954. Who invented the crescograph, an instrument for measuring the growth of a plant? He was Sir Jagdish Chandra Bose, J.C. Bose, right? So Jagdish Chandra Bose invented the crescograph. What does it do? It measures the growth of the plant. Okay, crescograph. Which mathematical genius was born in Erode in 1887? He was Sir S. Ramanujan. So S. Ramanujan was born in Erode in 1887. Your next question is, Albert Einstein along with which scientist described the fundamental particles known as bosons? So Albert Einstein along with scientist S. N. Bose, Satyendranath Bose, okay, described the fundamental particles known as bosons. Okay. Another question, who worked on thermal ionization in stars and laid the foundation for modern astrophysics? So who worked on thermal ionization in stars and laid the foundation for modern astrophysics? It was Meghnad Saha. Okay, so Meghnad Saha worked on thermal ionization in stars. Clear? Now, science. These are some of the interesting facts about the science which you should know. Here also, mixed questions are there about the science. Let's check it out. Born in 6th century BCE, he was often referred to as father of plastic surgery. Who is father of plastic surgery? It was Shushrut. Okay. Who was this great dermatologist? It was Shushrut. S-U-S-H-R-U-T-A. Whenever somebody asks you who is known as father of plastic surgery, he was Shushrut. Okay. What is surrounded by amniotic fluid? Amniotic fluid is found in the uterus of the woman and baby. An unborn baby is placed in the middle and amniotic fluid is surrounding that baby to protect that baby from shock or from jerk or from injury. Okay, so what is surrounded by amniotic fluid? It is an unborn baby who is surrounded by amniotic fluid. Which part of the body is made up of duodenum, jejunum and ileum? Yes, it is small intestine. You might have read in science, right? Intestine, small intestine is made up of duodenum, jejunum and ileum. Okay. What common antiseptic is obtained from seaweed? It is iodine. Okay. So the very famous antiseptic that is obtained from seaweed is iodine. Fifth question. Which part of the human body comprises 26 bones, 33 joints, 107 ligaments and 19 muscles and tendons. It is foot. Your foot contains 33 joints, 26 bones, 107 ligaments and 19 muscles and tendons. Okay. What is the word used to describe a packet of data sent by internet server to a browser and used to identify the user or track their access to the server? It is cookies, right? Sometimes the message comes, you are using our cookies. Do you accept? Yes, no, like that. So it is the cookies that describe packet of data sent by an internet server. Okay. What does an oncologist specialize in? Oncologist studies cancer, the treatment of cancer. Okay. So oncology is the study of cancer. Oncologists are the person who study about the treatment of cancer. So oncologists specialize in treatment of cancer. What is the mixture of two insoluble mixtures called? If two mixtures are insoluble, they are not mixing, we call it as emulsion. Okay, emulsified fat, emulsion, right? Yes. Which two precious metals are the constituents of alloy? Electrum is gold and silver. Electrum is made up of gold and silver, always remember, right? What is the name of ethical oath that a medical student traditionally takes on becoming a doctor? As soon as a medical student becomes a doctor, he takes an oath. That oath is called Hippocratic Oath. Always remember, that oath is called Hippocratic Oath. Which anesthetic is obtained by heating alcohol and sulfuric acid? It is ether. Okay? Ether is obtained by heating alcohol with sulfuric acid. What is the unique about the mandible? Mandible means jawbone. Okay? Mandible in relation to other bones in the human skull. Only bone in the skull that moves. In your whole skull bone, mandible only moves. No other bones move in your skull. Okay? If the domain name extension of India is .in, that means .in depicts India, google.in, that means India. Which country is .zh? It is South Africa. Suppose if extension is .in, it is India. If the extension is .zh, it is South Africa. Full form is with Africa. Okay? Another last question. Which part of the human body is made up of 7 pairs of true and false pair, 5 pair of false? True and false ribs are there. That means rib cage is there. Okay? Your rib cage. Okay? True and false bones are there. Okay? True pairs are joined to sternum, middle bone, while false pairs are not joined with the middle sternum, middle bone. Okay, so true and false bones are found in your rib cage. Okay, yes. This is all for today. Okay, note down your homework, everybody. You have to learn chapter number 52 to 55. Okay. So chapter number 52 to 55, you have to learn as a homework, okay? Till the next time we are going to meet, I am again going to come up with some more interesting facts and features. Till then, have a nice day. Have a wonderful day. Bye.